वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन टू माय न्यू लेक्चर। आई एम मोहम्मद तनवीर अहमद, लेक्चरर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, ओल्ड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ बांग्लादेश। आउटलाइन ऑफ द लेक्चर। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड द एनर्जी कंटेंट ऑफ इंडिविजुअल कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कैलकुलेट द एवरेज एनर्जी कंटेंट और कंपोजिट एनर्जी कंटेंट ऑफ द म्युनिसिपल सॉलिड वेस्ट on dry basis and on ash free dry basis. When energy is calculated from dry solid waste, it is called energy content on dry basis, and it is much more than the energy content calculated from moist solid waste. On the other hand, when the energy is calculated from dry soil and also the ash content is deduced from the total solid waste, then it is called energy content on ash free dry basis, and it is much more than the solid energy content of moist and energy content on dry solid waste of dry solid waste. Here we will first try to calculate the moisture content of municipal solid waste, and this is a table, and here these are the some components of solid waste, these are the percent by mass, and these are the moisture content, that is also in percentage. Here food waste is 15% of total 100 mass, that means food waste is 15 kg and the total waste is 100 kg. Similarly, paper waste is 45 kg within the total waste of 100 kg. Similarly, these are the percentage of moisture content. And from this data we will calculate the moisture content of the solid waste. So we need to calculate the moisture content. From the formula of moisture content we know that to calculate the moisture content we need two items, that is WW and WD. This WW means weight of moist waste, and this WD means weight of dry waste. That means we have to calculate the first we have to calculate the two items first. And the moisture content can be calculated in two ways, weight basis and dry basis. We will see this later. Let first calculate the value of WW and WD. Here this is the same table picked from the questions. These are the components, these are the percent by mass, and that means percent by mass, that means it is weight, as there are some moisture content in this solid waste, so this mass is weight basis, and these are given in data from question. If we see the question data here, these are the percent by mass, and we have just pick this column here, then these are the moisture content, and this value are in percentage. That means moisture content of food waste is 70%, paper is 6%, and similarly for others. This value are also given in question, and we have just picked this column here in this table. Let's see the question. These are the moisture content percentage, and we have just picked this value here in this column. Then we need to calculate WD. We have already get WW from question data, and now we need to calculate WD. WD, that means dry mass. So if the moisture content is 70%, that means dry mass is 30%. So total dry mass will be 15 into 30%, that means 4.5 kg, as the total content of food waste is 15% and dry mass is 30%. Similarly, for paper, total mass is 45, then here 45 into multiplied by 94%. 94% means if 6% is moisture content, then dry mass will be 94%. So total dry mass will be 45 into dry percentage, 94%. 43 42.3 kg. Similarly, other data have calculated and represented here. You students only need to show the calculation of first item, and you can also you can put this data in this table just by calculation, but just by calculating using your calculator. So here the sum of total dry mass is 78.95 kg, and the percent by mass is 100 kg as said in question, and if we sum this we will get 100 kg. We can now calculate moisture content in these two ways. First one is dry basis, and then first one is wet basis and then dry basis. When we compare the water content with weight of waste, then we will get moisture content on wet basis. And similarly, if we compare the weight of moisture with the dry content of waste, then we will get moisture content dry basis. So here this is the formula. We need to just input the value of WW and WD in this equation. Here we can see that the value of WW is 100 kg and WD is 78.95 kg. If we replace this data, here we will get the moisture content weight basis 21.05%. similarly, if we input that data WW and WD here in this equation, we will get moisture content on dry basis as 26.66%. So these are the calculation of moisture content. Then energy content, dry basis and ash free dry basis. We have calculated energy content in our previous lecture, but now this term is energy content on dry basis. So energy content on dry basis can be calculated using this equation. Here we can see this is energy content kilojoule per kg as discarded into 100 divided by 100 minus moisture content in percentage. So this is the only difference, that as discarded. We have calculated energy content before using normal soil solid waste, and as discarded means when it is assumed that the 100% or the total mass of the solid waste is dry, then the energy of that solid waste is called as discarded. That means energy of dry solid waste is called as discarded, no moisture content, total waste is dry, then the energy is as discarded. And it is not possible to get a solid waste as discarded, because every solid waste or every materials has some moisture. So dry energy content need to be calculated using this equation, and first we have to calculate the energy content as discarded, and then we have to calculate it the moisture content of the waste, and by deducing moisture content in the, as this form, we can calculate energy content on dry basis. So don't worry, as discarded energy basis, this will be calculated using a chart. There is a chart for specific solid waste on energy for energy content as discarded basis. We will pick energy content as discarded basis from this chart, and we need to calculate it only the moisture content. So If we can calculate moisture content, then easily we can calculate the dry content, energy content on dry basis. Similarly, energy content on ash free dry basis. This means energy content will be calculated without ash and assuming that solid waste is dry. So here this is the same this is the formula to calculate the energy content ash free dry basis. Here this is the same as first formula, energy content as discarded. That means assuming the 100% solid waste is dry, and deducing percentage of ash and moisture content from this equation, we can calculate energy content ash free basis. We have calculated, we need to calculate moisture content, then ash. We have learned how to calculate moisture content in this lecture, but ash, it is quite difficult to calculate the percentage of ash, but in most of the solid waste it is taken a constant value as 5% of ash. So ash need not to be calculated, we will use 5% as percentage of ash, and energy as discarded we can calculate it from a chart. So it is very simple to calculate the energy content in these two form. Now we will try to calculate the energy content on dry basis and ash free dry basis. So this is the typical data on inert residue and energy content of municipal solid wastes. So these are the some components of solid wastes, and this is the inert residue. Here, and this sign star marks here says that this is after combustion, or that means this inert residue will get after combustion process. That means we can say that we can say these are the items, or these are the percentage of, as this is, these are in percentage, so we can say these are the percentage of ash after combustion. What we will get after combustion? After combustion the only residue is ash, so these are the percentage of ash we can say, and this is these are range, and this is the typical value. We can use 5% instead of 2 to 8%. Similarly, this is energy kilojoule per kg. This sign indicates as discarded basis. That means considering the solid waste is 100% dry and the energy content will be in this range, and typical values are represented here. That means food waste, in food waste we will use typical energy value 4650. Similarly for others. So using this chart we can calculate the energy content as discarded basis. So let's see the example. Estimate the energy content of a solid waste sample with the following consumption. We have to calculate the energy content. What is the content on a dry basis and on ash free dry basis? Then we have to calculate it energy content on dry and ash free dry basis. These are the components of solid wastes. These are the percentages by mass, and total mass is 100. That means solid waste is 15%, paper is 45%, and thus total waste is 100%. These are the moisture content. As we know, to calculate the dry energy content we need to calculate it moisture content. So we have some, we need some data of moisture content, and these are the similar data which have we just seen in our previous example of moisture content. These are the same data we have picked here to calculate the energy content on dry basis and ash free dry basis. So these are the components, these are the percent by mass, and these are the moisture content. From this table or using this data we need to calculate it energy content on dry basis and energy content on ash free dry basis. So this is almost similar to the math which we have performed in our next, in our previous lecture, while we have calculated the energy content. So we are now in solution, or we are trying to calculate the energy content. First we have represented in this column the components, then here it is the percentage of mass, and this percentage of mass is also stated in question. Then this is energy kilojoule per kg. So first topic is food waste, and food waste energy content is 4650. So from where we have picked these values, or how we have calculated these values? We have calculated the value of energy content for food waste from the table. Not calculation, it is just the value we have picked from table. Let's see the table. Here our first item was food waste. So for food waste, the typical energy value is 4650. We have just used this value in our calculation table. Similarly, for paper, typical energy values are 16750. Let's see the table, data table, or standard data table again. Paper and typical values 16750. Similarly, for other components, we have just picked this energy content from using table 10.7. So this data just pick from table 10.7. Now this column is total energy kilojoule. So this is the mass, total mass, and this is the energy content kilojoule per kg. That means this energy is for 1 kg of waste. So total 15 kg of waste will have energy 15 into 4650 equal to something this value kilojoule. Similarly, if we multiply total mass and energy kilojoule per kg, we will get energy content, total energy content of paper waste, and similarly for other. And if we sum this total energy, this is something like this, 14,74,000 kilojoule. So we have calculated total energy, and this energy is based on as discarded basis, as we have used table 10.7, and table 10.7 is energy content of as discarded basis. Now to calculate the dry and HP dry basis energy content, we need another item, that is moisture content. So to calculate moisture content, we need to add this two column. First, this is the moisture content, and this moisture content are also stated in question. If we see the question, these are the moisture content. We have just picked this column here in this solution table. And similarly to the first example we have performed here in this lecture, we have just calculated the dry mass. If 70% is the moisture content, then dry mass will be 30%. So total dry mass will be 13% of 15, as the 15 kg is the total weight of food waste. So 15 into 30%, 4.5 kg is the dry mass. Similarly, paper 42.3 kg, and other components have been calculated and represent here in this table. And these are the similar math. This moisture content calculation is as similar as the problem we have solved here in our first math. We can see the moisture content calculation in this lecture. Yes, this data, same data we have just calculated here, and total dry mass stands 78.95 kg. So we calculated all the data required to calculate the calculated the dry content and energy value on HP dry basis. Let's now calculate it. First we need to calculate the moisture content. So moisture content weight basis, we have just used this formula, and this formula we have used in our first example in this lecture. So WW, value of WW, WW means waste, weight, that means moist weight of solid waste. Moist of weight of solid waste is 100 kg, and dry mass, this is dry mass, WD is 78.95 kg. So WD is 78.95 kg. Similarly, WW equal to 100. So moisture content weight basis is 21.05%. We can also calculate it moisture content on dry basis as our wish, but we have used here moisture content on weight basis. No need to calculation again moisture content on dry basis. We need only moisture content, any form, weight basis or dry basis. Here we have calculated again dry basis, and this value is 26.66%. Our first question was, if we again see the question, our first question was estimate the energy content of a solid waste sample with the following composition. That means we have to calculate it first, simply energy content. So our total energy is 14,74,000. So energy content, that means energy content will be always in kilojoule per kg. So if total energy is divided by the total waste, we will get energy content on kilojoule per kg. Here energy content on kilojoule per kg equal to 14,740 kilojoule per kg. So this energy content is as discarded basis. Why it is as discarded basis? Because we have used energy content as discarded basis to calculate the total energy. So this energy content is as discarded basis. Now we need to calculate it most energy content on dry basis. We have seen previous that energy content is dry basis can be calculated using this equation. Here this is as discarded energy, which is 14,740, and moisture content we have calculated two forms, 21.05 and 26.66. We can use any two of this value. So here we have used 21.05 moisture content, 21.05, and moisture content will always used here as percentage, not in decimal form, use always percentage. As this is 21.05%, so 21.05, not as decimal, 0.21. So energy content stands 18,670 kilojoule per kg. Similarly, energy content on ash free dry basis, let ash content 5%, as there is no data for ash, we have to assume ash content 5%, and it is always assumed that ash content is 5% for all and all average solid waste. So we have seen previous that ash content energy content can be calculated using this equation. Here energy content as discarded basis is 14,740, ash is 5%, use as percentage 5, moisture content is 21.05, and total energy content on ash free dry basis is 19,932 kilojoule per kg. So we can see again that as discarded energy is 14,740, energy content dry basis is 18,670 kilojoule per kg, which is greater than energy content as discarded basis, and energy content on ash free dry basis is 19,932 kg, which is greater than as discarded energy and energy content on dry basis, both of two, which I have said while it describe energy content on ash free dry basis and dry basis. So that is the end of our today's lecture. Thank you, everyone.